Pro Group Management. Workers' Comp that works for you.
Welcome to the Nevada Newsmakers. I'm Randy Thompson, sitting in for the vacation with Sam Shad. Today we'll be talking with Beau Keenan, the president of Dixon Realty, about the housing market. And rest assured, it's not crumbling anytime soon.
Get in on the Tamarack Casino's $175,000 Hidden Treasures Guaranteed Giveaway now through September 30th. Earn entries in the weekly drawings and win big during the two $35,000 grand prize giveaways. Your good times are at Tamarack Casino.
Modern boutique Ahern Hotel and Events Center in Las Vegas. Host meetings and events on two floors. Stay in luxurious rooms and suites. Unlimited branding opportunities. Regional Italian cuisine by Chef Mark Segrisi. Flexible event spaces. Full buyout options. Visit ahernhotel.com today.
I'm Jeff Gehrman, an investigative reporter with the Las Vegas Review-Journal. I'm your guide for season two of Mobbed Up, The Fight for Las Vegas.
You're in with every gangster and hoodlum in the United States.
I don't go for that, Mr. Kennedy. I don't go for that kind of action.
I was on television accused of fronting for the mob.
Subscribe to Mobbed Up, The Fight for Las Vegas, Season 2, today on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Like a traditional handmade basket, retail is woven into the fabric of life in Nevada. From big box to mom and pop, retail supports our communities in countless ways. Jobs for the disabled, team uniforms for kids, help for the elderly, and so much more. Retail employs over 1 in 10 workers. Retail supports Nevada, and we support retail.
RANNV.org.
Get in on the Tamarack Casino's $175,000 Hidden Treasures Guaranteed Giveaway now through September 30th. Earn entries in the weekly drawings and win big during the two $35,000 grand prize giveaways. Your good times are at Tamarack Casino.
Nevada Newsmaker Studio is located at the headquarters of the Nevada Trucking Association. Motion and purpose are a truck's greatest virtue.
This is Nevada Newsmakers with host Sam Shad, a no-holds-barred political forum. Now, from the Nevada Newsmakers broadcast headquarters, here is Sam Shad.
And welcome back to Nevada Newsmakers. I'm very happy to have on our show today Beau Keenan, who's the president of Dixon Realty. Hello, Beau.
Hello, Randy.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Oh, well, thank you for coming on. Yeah. So, Dixon Realty, one of the largest real estate companies, at least in Northern Nevada, but if
Correct.
Not the state.
Yeah.
And you're probably seeing a lot in the housing market, and a lot of us are going, what is going on? So, what is going on? Yeah. Why are there such crazy valuations and cash sales and all this stuff? What's going on in the real estate world?
Yeah, great question. So we like to kind of break it down to, you know, simple economics, and we'll kind of start with what's happening with inventory, what's happening with demand, and how is that translating to sales overall. So inventory-wise, what we are seeing is that this shortage of inventory that people talked about, we are starting to get a little bit of reprieve there as we're getting more standing inventory coming back on the market. And so you have two types of inventory. You have the new listings coming on the market, which we have plenty of new listings coming on the market, which is great. That's helping to supply for the demand that's there. Mm-hmm. What's been essentially not enough has been what we call standing inventory, the homes that have yet to sell when they've hit the market. Mm-hmm. And in the beginning of the year, that's when we kind of hit this all-time low. We had around 130 homes at one point available for sale that was standing inventory. Just to
put that, how many homes are in Northern Nevada, or at least in this area, Rios Parks?
Oh, that's a great question. I wish I knew exactly how many homes we had. But just to put in perspective, we typically have around 1,100 to 1,200 homes available for sale.
Okay.
So you think about, I mean, we came down like 80, 90%.
This is 10% of it.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Okay. Yeah.
And as soon as we hit that, then we started to climb. So the last 5 months we've been climbing. And right now we have about 500 homes available for sale.
Okay.
So that's a great improvement. But still, think about it, that's still half of what we usually have. So you're still going to feel this inventory is tight. Mm-hmm. But when you look at that and you look at, again, the demand, you have some people worried that, oh, the demand is slowing. It's not that demand is slowing. It's just that we're finally getting more options because inventory is increasing. So we had, just for example, last month, we had about 650 home sales. That's typical.
Okay.
So we're having plenty of inventory for sales. So demand is steady, which is great. We just have the standing inventory increasing. But what's helped with the demand, of course, is our mortgage rates. You know, mortgage rates are, you know, we've heard this all-time low, and they truly are. I mean, now our average mortgage rate's less than 3%.
Yeah.
So, which is fantastic because that helps with that affordability issue that we're going to talk about here. You know, every 1% in a mortgage rate increase or decrease affects a family's purchasing power by about $100,000.
Wow.
So if you think about our median price, it did go up significantly. You know, we're up to about $530,000 now. That's, you know, close to about a 30% rise from this time last year. But with the mortgage rates being down close to 1%, you can almost make up that difference. That's why we've had that demand. So people are surprised, how are we still affording homes? It's because the mortgage rates have helped.
Yeah.
But they can't go much lower now, so.
No, I refinanced at 2.85, so yeah, that's not bad.
That is
I remember
bad.
When I bought my first home, this was in Maryland, when I lived in Annapolis, and it was $120,000, but it was 12% interest.
Yeah, that's.
And so that's all I could afford.
Quadruple.
Exactly. It's like, and so when I look at like my payment then was what I would be equivalent to buying a $600,000 home probably now. It's just so it's just amazing to see those interest rates really do matter, and that really does drive it, the affordability part of it, at least for the folks that can at least get the down payment on it.
That's right. Yep. Yeah. Which obviously prevents a lot of people from even getting into the market.
Mm. So we've seen a lot of cash buys, and I know it seems to be around 25-30% a month.
Right now.
Is that all Californians driving that?
That I would say predominantly, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. And Northern California is obviously our biggest feeder market.
Mm-hmm.
And Southern California as well, we do have an increase coming from there as well. I don't know if I can say this, but you know, the going joke is that Governor Newsom was voted the best realtor in 2021 in Nevada. But yeah,
I can see a lot of people probably will agree with that. Yes.
But yes, no, we absolutely. That is a big part of it, and it's all just when you look at it relative. You know, when they're selling their home there for a 3-bed, 2-bath for $1,200, you know, a home here that's at $600,000-$800,000 is very affordable to them,
mm-hmm.
and they'll absolutely put down all cash to buy that home.
Yeah, well, we just went down to Los Gatos, Saratoga for the weekend, and even on a Saturday, the line of cars is backed up. These people are trying to get to Santa Cruz, which is about normally a 20-minute drive, and it turned into about an hour and a half because of just the backup on a Saturday. So it's just nutty to see the volume of people down there, and they are very consolidated. And you come up here and we complain about our 5-minute rush hour. And of course, it has gotten worse at the Spaghetti Bowl, but.
Yes, due to construction things there. But we really, again, it's all relative, right? You think about, you know, we still have it pretty good.
We do. So what's driving our quality of life up here for these Californians? I mean, besides just a home, is it, what as a seller of homes, what are you out there pitching that says why you should come to Reno?
So I think one of the first and foremost things is outdoor amenities. You know, people love, if you love to be outdoors in our 300 plus days of sun, California obviously is known for being a sunny area, but we're just as much sun as they have. And then we have beautiful Lake Tahoe, surrounding lakes, mountain bike trails, skiing. A lot of people who do come here like the Four Seasons. You know, obviously we're selling that. And then the area itself has, I mean, the amount of events that we have, and of course COVID kind of affected that, and we finally felt like, oh wow, we really miss all those events that we have, whether it be the hot air balloon races, the air races themselves, you know, hot August nights. It was great to see all the people out there.
Mm-hmm.
Those things, people really come here and see, wow, you have a great community, and those type of events make us quite a bit different and unique than other areas.
I can see that.
Yeah.
So you're seeing stronger inventory, still good values, low interest rates. Are you seeing stability anytime in the future?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we are. I think the stability is about to hit us because we know that interest rates won't go much lower. So we've already absorbed about that $100,000 in price appreciation that we can. And so the first 6 months of the year, we gained about 16 to 17% appreciation. We really forecast the next 4 or 5 months of the rest of the year is probably going to maybe have 4% appreciation.
Okay.
So we're really going to stabilize now. That doesn't mean things are crashing.
Right.
You know, we often get that, oh, the market's crashing.
No.
Just because we haven't been going up 2% every month. That's not sustainable. So the stabilization we really feel is here. We feel 21 and the rest of 22 are going to be pretty stable.
Okay. Yeah. Well, now, market crash does come up a lot, and this is not 2006.
Not at all. Not even. I mean, the fundamentals are completely different.
Mm-hmm.
And the three big ones, if you don't mind me pointing out. So one, of course, is just the mortgage underwriting. We know that it was so easy to borrow back in 2006. Easy to a fault. And you had people buying 4, 5, 6, 7 homes. Of course, they were going to foreclose on all of those. You know, at this point, you have one person buying maybe just one home, and the amount of work they have to do to get that home is incredible, right?
Mm-hmm.
The average credit score to buy a home right now is above 700. before it was below 640. That's okay. A huge difference. Someone has that type of credit score, you know that they're going to be sticking it out with their home.
Well, good.
And then equity, you know, they have more equity than they've ever had in their home. Mm-hmm. If someone's about to lose their home right now, not only will they sell it, they'll sell it and pocket a lot of money. So why would they short sell? Why would they foreclose? Yep.
So it's encouraging that we're not going to be crashing anytime soon.
Yeah, unless it's some black swan event that you and I can't forecast. But really, the fundamentals underneath the housing market right now are very strong.
Well, good. We're going to be back to talk a little bit about affordable housing right after this.
I can't do it. Stupid, like my mom.
We can't do anything at Mommy's because you won't pay child support.
Dad said you cheated, and he's not even sure he's my dad.
Mommy said you left both of us, so she isn't going to let me see you.
I look just like my father.
I'm divorce attorney Marilyn York, and I may represent men, but hate has no gender, only casualties. Please, stop sacrificing your children in your war against your ex.
Because of UMC, I'm putting my free time to good use.
Because of UMC, she keeps me on my toes.
Because of UMC and this guy, I'm here.
UMC, the highest level of care in Nevada.
The signs and symptoms of cataracts can start out small with subtle changes in your vision. So don't wait. Be proactive and take your vision into your own hands. If you're experiencing the onset of cataracts or just have questions, contact your eye care professional or call Eye Care Associates of Nevada today. Dr. Hiss has years of experience specializing in the surgical correction of eye disorders and has completed over 84,000 vision-correcting procedures. At Eye Care Associates of Nevada, we'll change the way you look at the world.
Finish. Dad? Why are you learning? This place is great.
Huh?
You gotta try this.
Wow, this stuff is great. People are gonna love it.
Yes. Yes, they were.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And we're back on Nevada Newsmakers with Bo Keenan, the president of Dixon Realty. So we've been talking a little bit about the current housing market, but the biggest challenge that our area, and I think every area in the country, is facing is affordability. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of pressures on builders to build affordable housing, but yet there's a lot of restrictions that government keep putting on to builders that make it, well, more expensive to build. So what are some of the challenges we're seeing here with affordable housing in the Northern Nevada area? As well, frankly, even Las Vegas. I mean, they're even having issues.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's several fold, but you're absolutely right. One is we need more collaboration from just local government, state government, to help us with just easing restrictions and the guidelines for development. You know, the amount of parking spaces that you have to have. And if you think about that one particular restriction, in affordable housing, a lot of times, they don't all have lots of cars. We just need to be able to build by an area that has lots of public transit. So to have the parking restrictions in place in that case and scenario doesn't make sense, right? Mm-hmm. So I think it needs to be a case-by-case scenario, and they need to look at projects forward-facing as far as, okay, what's maybe some things that we could relax on? Because for this particular scenario, it doesn't make sense. Mm-hmm. Instead of just having this blanket statement as, you know, it has to fit these guidelines. So collaboration there really needs to increase. The cost of land right now is prohibiting a lot of projects. Mm-hmm. And so one way for us to help with that is to put together community housing land trusts. Right now, the Community Foundation has actually formed Nevada's first. Mm-hmm. And so the Community Foundation of Northern Nevada, with that, they put together the Village on Sage Street. Not sure if you heard about that project.
Yeah, right.
That came from that.
Okay.
And that afforded is about 400 units for people who make what they say about 60% of AMI. And so that's the annual
average median income.
Yes, average median income for the area.
Yep.
So that, and then also they just acquired several acres in Golden Valley that they're going to be building single family homes on. And that's what you're talking about. How do we get to, instead of just apartments, how do we get to that? So if we can acquire some land or have that actually given to the land trust, you take that out of the equation, it really does bring the price of the homes down significantly for our developers. And so that's going to be one way that will help significantly. So reduce the restrictions, collaborate with city governments, and then as well as just give some incentives to these developers, take out some of the risk, as well as give them the land at cost, at a less cost, or just gift it. That will help us significantly in that. But it's going to take some time.
Yeah. I was talking to a developer a few years ago. He was developing up in the North Valleys.
Yeah.
And he presented his plan to the city council, the Reno City Council, and he had a city council member going, you have to put in sidewalks and gutters. And he was saying, no, we are looking at how we're building communities, and it's different that nowadays we're not putting in gutters because gutters flow, and I'm not sure of all the reasoning. But
yeah.
So here you have city council people who are trying to dictate what is the best best land planning.
Correct.
And they're out of touch. They're 10, 20 years behind.
Correct.
So there's some education there. The developers need to be saying, look, we don't need less restrictions. We need our ability to build properly.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so when people say, oh no, we can't have less restrictions. No, a lot of times it's just let us expand and increase our ability to better plan for help of rainwater. I know, especially Lemon Valley with the flooding up in that area.
Yeah.
So there's ways to build that take those into effect, but it's like the council people and the planning commission are 10, 20 years behind.
Correct, yeah. Let them propose new ideas. Be open to the new ideas. Because a lot of those restrictions were put in place at the time because that's what you had to work with.
Mm-hmm.
But you're absolutely right. Where times are now, where we've come, they have to be open to it and let them hear out that process, because you're absolutely right. We've actually come a long ways with where the development can go and what we need and don't need.
Right. And I was talking to another city council person. We were talking about a development downtown, and we talked about a parking lot. And she goes, you don't need a parking lot. No, people aren't going to have cars.
Right.
People shouldn't be parking downtown. People should be riding their bikes.
Yes.
So now you have agendas. You have a group out there. We need to put in all these Tesla charging stations, despite the fact that there's no Teslas downtown. I mean, it's
that's right.
So you've got an agenda, it seems, of mm-hmm. and it's all coming around, the global warming aspect of things, or climate mm-hmm. change, is yeah. we need to get people to stop driving their cars. So therefore, you're not going to have parking spaces where you live. So there's some political stuff that's kind of gotten pretty frustrating.
Just driving some of those. Absolutely. I agree 100%.
It's kind of strange. Yeah. So in the sense of downtown versus out of town, like Lemon Valley and mm-hmm. stuff, where are you seeing the need for affordable housing? Is it where the workers are? Is it, like you said, along the transportation lines?
Mm-hmm.
And what would be the better, what would be a better plan for the city of Reno to be looking at how we better build affordable housing?
I think it is both, because I do think that you have a subset of people who want that urban lifestyle and they're fine to use public transit, but you also have the families who they want to feel like they own a piece of land. They actually have some room to move.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to get that, you know, within the McCarran Loop as an example. That's going to be out in those outlying areas. So again, the Community Foundation, really, I think they did great. They had two small projects. One was urban infill and one was out in Golden Valley. They both accomplished those two things. One gives people, again, that affordable housing where they can come in, they don't need to have cars, they can have public transit. And then they have single family homes where they're actually leasing the land back to the owner, the person that's buying it, for a very, very small cost. But that brings the home price down close to $100,000 now.
Wow.
And so, yes, it's, again, you don't necessarily own the land underneath you, but they give them free rein for the most part to do what they want on that. So I think we're trying to accomplish both, to be honest, Randy. I don't think it's just one.
Yeah.
So yes, we need higher density projects, but people still want that American dream.
That's true. All
as
right.
Well.
And we'll be back to talk about more of the American dream right after this.
7 at 7 is available anytime, anywhere.
I'm Riley Smith with your Vegas Golden Knights. Watch 7 minutes of nonstop news from the Las Vegas Review Journal.
Streaming on LVRJ.com and YouTube, powered by the Las Vegas Review Journal.
Before the masks, before the distancing, before the world changed, UMC was ready. Our response to COVID-19 began before the crisis did, with our own team of infectious disease experts who've spent their careers planning for this moment. With a pandemic response plan we'd practiced again and again, and by blazing new trails in large-scale testing, including every patient we admit. Always ready. UMC.
Each day, the Children's Advocacy Alliance partners with leaders, legislators, and families across Nevada to improve children's health, education, economic well-being, and safety. We recognize Nevada will be no better than the state of its children. Be a part of this change. Be a supporter of the Children's Advocacy Alliance. For more information, go to caanv.org.
The Do It Right guys at Nevada Heating have one mission.
Your air conditioner breaks down today. We fix it today. Why sweat for days while your air is down when Nevada Heating can get the job done today and you can get cool again? For nearly 50 years, locally owned Nevada Heating has been getting the job done right. Call today at 323-5585 or see us online at nevadaheating.com.
Serving Our Kids Foundation's mission is to serve homeless, at-risk, and food insecure children in grades K through 8 throughout Southern Nevada. During the pandemic, Serving Our Kids has seen a 42% increase in the number of children served, providing more than 4,500 meals to kids in over 100 schools weekly. Serving Our Kids is powered by community support and volunteers. To learn how you can help, visit servingourkids.org.
7 at 7 is available anytime, anywhere.
I'm Riley Smith with your Vegas Golden Knights. Watch 7 minutes of nonstop news from the Las Vegas Review-Journal.
Streaming on LVRJ.com and Twitter, powered by the Las Vegas Review-Journal.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And we're back on Nevada Newsmakers with Bo Keenan, the president of Dixon Realty. So part of the American dream that we talked about as owning a home is also owning homes and then renting them out and making money and being a landlord. And that's been a real challenge this past year. And we have the CDC overstepping its bounds, in my opinion, and putting in a moratorium on not being evicted from a rental unit. And I know there are very tragic stories out there of people who've lost their jobs, so I'm not being at all, I'm sympathetic to that. But absolutely, I also know there's people who have bought homes to rent them and they're not getting paid and they're in trouble. So come September or October, I guess now, the CDC eviction is supposed to be expired.
That's correct.
But Nevada passed a law, AB 486. Mm-hmm. So how is that working or not working in our community?
So the AB 486, which essentially is effective on July 1st, so that's already in play. And regardless of the CDC moratorium being up or not, they said that they're already going to go with that. That's the more conservative for the tenant. So it is more of a pro-tenant law that's been in place. I think that will go through July of 2023. The goal of that is to give rental assistance to those who are in actual need, which is then also good for the property owner, because then that renter who is truly being affected by COVID can actually pay. The problem that you brought up is exactly that, is the person who really isn't making an effort to actually be paying their bills, and they're taking advantage of this loophole in the system. So this 486 bill, this essentially allows the renter to, they will stay the eviction process for 30 days to go ahead and make a formal plea to get that money. The problem is, again, for someone who's not been paying even pre-COVID or during COVID, but has the opportunity to taking advantage of that, that's what really is unfortunate.
Yeah, and
that's
you're 18 months into this, and not longer now. Yeah, 18 months
now,
without paying rent
it out
or
now,
without collecting rent.
That's a problem. So the good news is that, as we talked about earlier, about 95% of rents are being collected.
Good.
And we know that just from at large within the Reno-Sparks area, but also within the walls of Dixon. We have about 800 homes under management. And again, it's still 95%, and that was pre-COVID. So that 5% who will try to take advantage of any system out there are taking advantage of it.
Yeah.
And so if you're one of the unlucky ones that has a renter that's doing that, I don't think that 486 is going to increase that happening. It's just going to give those who are going to do it the ability to hold up that process of being evicted. And if they do get rental assistance, you won't be able to evict them while they're there at that point for any.
And that rental assistance means that they need to be paying you, the landlord,
correct,
right?
That's absolutely.
Are the landlords also able to collect, if they're not getting it from their renter, is there a program where landlords can get money for the feds?
Not that I know of yet.
Okay.
But I think that the goal is, if you know that your tenant's having that issue, you're going to urge your tenant to go through this process to get it.
Okay.
So.
Yeah. And I understand it once they leave and apply, so let's say they'd applied in August, don't they have like 3 months until they actually can be, like, they don't have to pay for another 3 months? Or are they supposed to pay right away? If they've applied for the rental assistance, it can take up to 3 months to get that assistance. There
correct.
We go. I knew I could say that eventually.
That's exactly right.
Yeah. So you could go another 3 months without even getting paid.
Getting paid.
Okay.
Yep. And they're not going to back pay that yet either, which is...
So do you think once this moratorium is up, and even if it's not till July of 2023 for us, do you then see some foreclosures coming on the market?
Not necessarily. Okay. Again, because what that homeowner has in their back pocket is appreciation.
Okay.
While yes, they weren't getting those rents, they will have the ability to collect from that appreciation when they go to sell the home. And yes, I do think that we'll have an increase of some that will sell because of like, I'm fed up with this, get me out of this.
I can imagine.
Some will realize that, well, while that was difficult, my house did appreciate 30% during that period of time, right? Mm-hmm. And so maybe I'll stay the course. And it is a great hedge against inflation. We know that physical assets have always been that. So I don't think it's gonna be this influx that people are talking about where you're gonna have, you know, everyone selling their residential homes that they've had for rent.
Well, they're probably going to turn into Airbnbs.
That's correct. Yeah, exactly.
a lot less hassle.
Yeah, that's a whole other topic. Well, it is for now, but now there's all kinds of restrictions coming down on those. So
yep.
We'll see what happens.
Well, thank you for the update on the real estate market. I appreciate it. We'll have you back again.
Sounds great, Randy.
We'll be back right after this.
Brian Culpa Photography was born in the rolling hills of Massachusetts, and now he can help you experience the stunning beauty of Nevada in a whole new way through the power of flight. Flying has always been a passion for Brian, and at Brian Culpa Photography, he can make your imagination soar. Brian has the creative mind and tools to tell your unique story. Experience the bird's eye view at brianculpaphotography.com.
Hi, my name's Marilyn Miner, and I'm sure you'd agree that Nevada's a very special place to live. I was born here, and my husband and I have raised our family here. I feel it's a privilege to live and work in the Truckee Meadows. I especially enjoy helping my clients reach their real estate goals. Sometimes the smallest details provide the greatest satisfaction. I'd be complimented to talk to you about your next move.
Call Marilyn Miner at Dixon Realty, 742-1280, or log on to marilynminer.com.
Safety. We all think about it. You think about it when he buckles in, when you check your mirrors and put away your phone. RTC thinks about safety too. In fact, we create it. Center turn lanes mean fewer blind spots. Bike lanes keep cyclists and you safe. Roundabouts reduce injury collisions. And all these crosswalks are designed to keep families like yours safe. Safety is your priority and it's ours too. Every day, in everything we do.
Pro Group Management specializes in providing industries with the necessary components to satisfy and exceed workers' comp requirements. Every business has unique needs and specific regulations. Pro Group Management stays ahead of the curve, providing up-to-date services to keep your industry in top form. Discover how we simplify your tasks, improve efficiency, and reduce expense to keep you moving in a positive direction. Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
Thanks for watching and listening. You can catch us anytime on our new YouTube channel, Nevada Newsmakers. Thank you. Hey, Mom.